What's up, everyone? Big Doug here. As you can see, it's a gorgeous fall day. It's sunny out. The farmer came and plowed out their soybeans, so all we got left is dirt. It's the leaves are turning. Look at that beautiful fall. Not quite end of fall. Gorgeous, gorgeous weekend. A little cool at first, but I think we're going to get close to 70. Or in the 70s is next 4 days up in our neck of the woods. So today, it's a good day right now. It's actually pretty warm. I think it was in the 60s as I came home from a gun show. And as you see in my title, there's some birds out there. I don't know if I can get them. They just took off. I'm kind of, at this point, I think I'm gun showed out, because I don't know if gun shows, the question is it worth it? You know, you pay $6 up to $8 per person, and the very first gun show I was at last year, the first time ever, I bought some ammo. There was pretty reasonable, 22s, bought some 9mm. Went to a second gun show in the area about a month or so later. Didn't get anything, and then I went to one near Pittsburgh, which was nice. It was a nice big area. I mean, it's not a super gun show, but it's probably one of the biggest ones I was at last year, and I didn't get anything just because I couldn't really buy anything other than weapon or ammo, but I had a fun time. And then this year, I didn't really go to any gun shows until recently. I went to one maybe last month in my area again. Then I went one up near Cleveland here just recently. I just wanted to go to it because there's a network. There's a sponsor that hosts the one between Cleveland, Akron, and the Youngstown Warren area near PA border. And like I said, I've been to the one in Akron, been to one in the Warren Niles area, Youngstown area, and never went to the one in Cleveland. In Cleveland, it's at the fairgrounds up near Cleveland. And hey, I'm back. Sorry, my battery went dead, so I charged up for a little bit, see how far I can get. I don't want to make this a long video, but as I was mentioning, you know, I've been to a couple gun shows. They all seem to be pretty the same to me. I guess, like I said, I probably won't go to many more gun shows for a couple reasons. A, I can get ammo better at the gun stores and online, and even guns. I mean, new ones. Maybe you can find a deal on used ones. People are walking around trying to sell theirs. You might get a good deal that way. But to find new rifle, shotguns, handguns, new ones, I think gun stores and for me, gun broker, you can find a good deal sometimes. So I don't know. I think I'm done for gun shows for a while. And as I was at the one in Cleveland, it was a pretty good size. I mean, they have it like in three buildings. And I was in the last building. As we were getting ready to walk out, I came across this. I came across this. I almost lost hope on gun shows. Yes, Nate Square Tactical Holster. Now, the one that's in here is the one I won from South Carolina Mike through Gun Wild One, Big J, because he actually won this and he passed it on to me, which I still like this. Don't get me wrong, I'm going to be using this for my other guns. But what I came across was the professional one with the, I believe this is, I don't know if this is Kydex, but as you can tell, it's not the nylon. But I saw the price. Same price as online. And I'm like, oh, okay, it's cool. They didn't mark it up. Because a lot of stuff at gun places, they mark things up more than you get them at gun stores. And I talked to this guy. Do I have his card on me? No, darn it. He's a supplier, I guess, from Ohio. The first time I've seen this Nate Square at any of the gun shows in my area, because they're originally from the South, I think Carolina States, I think. They're Nate, the two Nates who owns this company. And, of course, it comes with a nice sticker. I like it. I think I came with the other one that I got when I won. But anyways, professional one. I wanted to get this one, and I was going to order it eventually. For this price, because I really like the material. This thing is really comfortable on up against your body. As you can tell, this hasn't stained because of my, either my heat, great heat coming from my body, or unlike my DeSantis holster, it got pretty dirty that pretty easily. So this is my new one. As you can tell, this is a little bigger because I want this one. This might fit more of a smaller compact gun, but I want it, and I'm going to use it. And like I said, as I showed you before, it stuck out briefly part of the handle because this is made for a little smaller gun, but I still love this, but I'm going to love this even more because here, just for this purpose reason, one of the reasons, A, I can reholster this. I gotta get used to twisting and pulling it. But with this, I can draw it out, but I would have to take this off to reholster it and re-attach it to my pants. Here, since it's, you know, it's already formed, I just stick it back in. Hopefully when you pull it, you use it for self-defense. You don't have to worry about holstering it, but I could use this probably for target shooting. That's why I use my my other paddle holster that came with my XDM when I'm out target shooting, because it's easier to holster and unholster, where this was a little harder to use. And I only use this for concealed carry. This I'll use for concealed carry and maybe for target shooting at ranges, my backyard or a friend's house or whatever. But I just want to share this. And I mentioned for the price, and they don't charge that much for shipping. I looked into it, it's like $3. You can order 10 holsters, it's just $3, which is kind of cool. T-shirts are really reasonable. I was gonna get a T-shirt eventually. But anyways, the guy at the guns gave it to me out the door, there's no tax, $65. So, you know, I saved a few bucks on the holster and didn't have to worry about shipping. And I'm happy. I finally got something at a gun show that, you know, because I don't know. I walk around going, ammo prices have gone up since last year. I'm not going to pay for that. I was looking for 10/22s, the takedown rifles, and that's almost like 50, 100 bucks more that I can get them online or at my local gun store. So it's like, you know what? I just don't understand the gun stores, the gun shows. They're just overpriced, in my opinion. So it's fun. Don't get me wrong. I like looking around at some of the newer and older stuff. I mean, it's just fun walking around, but when you pay $6 to $8, you hope that you buy something. And anyways, I finally got something, but I won't go back to another gun show unless it's a huge, huge, mega, I don't know, extravaganza gun show that I'll go to, pay 10, 12, you know, whatever, and maybe there'll be some newer stuff that's at a reasonable price, you know, that you would get at a gun store. So anyways, just wanted to share that. My deal of the day, well, not really a deal. Yeah, it's a deal. I'm happy. It's a nice day out, nice weekend. It's supposed to be a great week, and I hope you guys enjoy yours. And until then, take care, everyone. Bye.